Hare Krishna. Without going deeply into one tradition, we can't appreciate any tradition. When we are embarking on a spiritual journey, we often feel a little hesitant. If I take to one path, then maybe I will become narrow-minded, I'll become bigoted, and I will not be able to appreciate different paths. While this is a danger, it is also possible, and it's also probable, that actually by not committing to any one path, we may end up not appreciating any path. Krishna says in the Bhagavad-Gita 4.11, Mama Vartamanu Vartante Manushyah Partha Sarvashah. He says, all paths lead to me, Krishna says. So, all people are on my path. That means if we consider a mountain, then if we consider the top of the mountain to be spiritual consciousness, to be God consciousness, and the bottom of the mountain to be material consciousness, then there are many paths up the mountain. And whoever is climbing up that mountain is on the path to Krishna. At the same time, if somebody stays at the bottom of the mountain and starts comparing various paths, okay, that person may get some understanding. But on the other hand, if the person climbs up, say, half the way up the mountain, and then that person is talking with someone, maybe communicates with someone else who's also climbed up half the mountain, both of them will be able to appreciate each other much better. This person, because they've risen up, and they're also seeing the mountain, the top, the bottom, the sideways, from various sides. That's why they will be able to appreciate the mountain far better than what they would appreciate from the bottom itself. And another example we could use is of language. Ultimately, whichever spiritual path we follow, that is meant for connecting with and communicating with God, with the ultimate reality. And if we learn one language well, then that enables us to better appreciate other languages. We may have to put in effort to learn the other languages, but if we have learned the mechanics, the art, the both the mechanic, the craft and the art of one language, then we can appreciate better the craft and the art of other languages. But if we are illiterate, then we won't be able to appreciate any language at all. Similarly, if we stay uncommitted, then we stay spiritually illiterate. We don't connect with Krishna in any way, and therefore we don't connect with the ultimate reality, whatever be the name we give to it. And because of not being connected with that ultimate reality, we end up actually feeling spiritually unconnected. So if we're not to stay spiritually literate, then we have to start embarking on one path. And if that path is right for us, that will be revealed to us by the inner conviction, the inner realization, the inner illumination that will come by following that path. And if it is not the right one for us, that will also be revealed to us. And by that, we can move onwards in our spiritual journey. So by progressing on one spiritual path, we can appreciate other spiritual paths better. So it's not that committing to one path will make us narrow-minded, rather it will make us educated. It will make us evolved, by which we can appreciate other paths. Of course, if we follow that one path in a narrow-minded, sectarian way, thinking my path is the best path, then certainly we can become cut off from other traditions. But not all paths are like that, and not all practitioners are like that. So if we understand the commonality of the purpose, then we can appreciate the diversity of the paths while also committing ourselves to our path firmly. Thank you. Hare Krishna.